All right, so this video is all about helping you get started building a website or building a blog using WordPress. In this video, I'm going to show you how to get WordPress hosting with my favorite company for WordPress hosting, which is Dreamhost, and it's actually the same company that I use for my own website. We're going to show you how to get WordPress installed, which is, if you follow along with these instructions, it's ridiculously easy. It's basically, you don't even have to worry about it. It just happens. And then lastly, I'm going to show you how you can set up email that goes along with your hosting, so you can have an email address or actually even multiple email addresses at your own domain. So for example, I've got Tim at Real Website Hints, and you can have your name at your domain or different email addresses at your domain. I'm going to show you all how to do that in this video. It's going to be really easy if you follow along with these directions, and it's going to be great. So I'm really excited to show this to you guys. And one of the things about all of my tutorials and all of the advice that I give on my website and on my YouTube channel is when I'm making these videos, what I'm thinking to myself is, what would I tell a friend of mine if they wanted to, in this example, get started with WordPress and website hosting? What would I tell them? And that's sort of what's going through my mind when I'm making these videos. And so if you like that idea, definitely give me a thumbs up. If you have questions about how to get started or about this video, leave them in the comments down below, because my aim is to do the best job I can at helping you guys get started. And so I want to know, you know, what's going well and what you guys are finding a little bit confusing, so the next video I make, I can improve. So this video, we're going to be talking about Dreamhost, and as I said before, Dreamhost is the hosting company that I use myself for my own website, and the reason why I recommend them and the reason why I'm actually kind of excited about making this video is I don't feel like Dreamhost gets enough recognition for what they do and what they offer. I think, you know, one of the things about Dreamhost compared to some of the other hosting companies is that they're an employee-owned company. They're not owned by some big, giant conglomerate. I also find that their pricing is really good, and right now when I'm making this video, they're actually offering some really good introductory pricing. But one thing that I've noticed, and one thing you should definitely be checking when you're looking at these introductory rates, is what happens to the rate after that introductory period. And what I found is that Dreamhost has some of the lowest rates after the introductory period. I think right now, for the hosting that we're going to sign up for in this video, it's $9.99 a month. And if you compare that to some of the other top hosting providers, it's anywhere between $15.99 a month and $17.99 a month or more after the introductory period. So even over the long run, you're saving some money with Dreamhost. The other thing I like about Dreamhost is when you get started with them, and if you register your domain with them, and that's kind of the easiest way when you're, especially when you're just starting out, is to have the domain and your hosting with the same company. It just saves you that time and effort from linking the two together, which is usually fine, but it just, why waste extra time if you don't have to? So having those two things together, and I like Dreamhost's registration. As a matter of fact, all of the websites that I register on Dreamhost. And one of the reasons why is because they offer the domain privacy for free. And basically what that means is that when you register your website, instead of showing your personal information and phone number and address, it shows Dreamhost's information. And the reason why that's good is basically just to prevent yourself from getting spam phone calls, spam email, spam or just junk mail in the mail. It just saves you from all of that hassle and all of that clutter that you just don't need. You can also opt to turn that off. I don't really understand why you would want to do that. But I just think that the fact that they offer that for free and it's just standard right out of the gate is great. And a lot of other companies charge you extra for that. And the email hosting at this price is really great. It's a great way to get started. I do think eventually you're going to want to move up to something like G Suite or Microsoft Office 360 or some other email plan. But for just getting started, this is going to be a great way to get started. And I'll show you exactly how to configure and set up your email or multiple email addresses. So if you're ready to dive in and get started, let's go ahead and do this. And if you want to use the link down below, that helps to support this channel. And that'll also make sure that you're in the right starting place for this video. I'm Tim from realwebsitehints.com. And let's go ahead and do this. Okay, so if you use that link that's down below the video, that should take you here. And what we want to do is, since we're building a WordPress website, we want to use this WordPress tab here. And for this video, we're going to use the WordPress Basics. That's going to be sort of the lowest cost to entry to get into WordPress that Dreamhost offers. I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And now if you're interested in DreamPress, which is sort of the more advanced options, and there's some great features that it has, and I think it's even good for beginners if you have extra money to spend to build your website. I've got a separate video on that, and I will link to that in the description down below and up above this video. But right now, let's look at these two WordPress plans. The first thing I want to point out is that with Dreamhost, you get a 97-day money-back guarantee. So if you're not happy with the hosting, or if you just change your mind about wanting to do this at all, you can always get your money back within that first 97 days. And I'm going to suggest that you go for, well, it's really up to you. I'm going to suggest that you go for 1 year. I think it takes some time to build and get your website going. So I think a year is a good amount of time to sort of test that out. If you know that you're committed to making a website, some website, even if it's not this first website that you start, I mean, going through 3 years is definitely a great bargain because you can get this introductory price for the whole 3 years, which is really good. And also, according to this too, it renews at a lower amount after that introductory period. And the great thing about the WordPress Unlimited plan is that you get unlimited websites. So, you know, you might be just starting with one first website, but you might have some other ideas and you might want to try those out. So you can just go ahead and do that because you already have the hosting paid for in order to do that. But for this video, I'm going to go for the 1 year. Doesn't really change the price for the unlimited. The unlimited's the same price for that introductory period. And as you can see here, the introductory price after that promotional period is $9.95 a month, which is still a really good deal for the hosting that we're getting here. And the other reason why I recommend the unlimited plan is because you get the email included at your domain, and you can have as many email addresses as you want, and you can even have different email addresses at different domains. So if you're trying out different ideas, this is a great way to do that. So go ahead and click on sign up now. And if you know which domain name you want to use, or if you were ready to just go ahead and try a domain name, you can do that now, or you can click choose a domain later. And you can even start building your website without a domain, but it's a little bit easier if you already pick your domain right now. So let's go ahead and we're gonna do that. Okay, so a quick note about choosing a domain name. I still definitely recommend for most people you want to go with .com. So when you're typing in your domain name, type it in with .com. I recommend trying to come up with something catchy, easy to say, easy to spell, that's three or four words. I think that's going to be sort of the best results. And if you've got somebody else who can just look over the name that you choose, just to make sure that, you know, when all the words run together, you don't see anything weird in there, some weird names. The other thing to think about too is you don't want to use somebody else's trademarked name. So like if you have a blog that talks about Microsoft, for example, you shouldn't say, you know, Tim's Microsoft blog, because Microsoft might come after you because that's their trademark and they're required by law, actually, in order to maintain their trademark, to defend it and keep other people from using it. So you don't want to use a trademark name in your domain name. Other than that, you know, be creative, keep it simple, make sure that it's easy to say and easy to understand. And that's sort of my best advice on coming up with a domain name. So the name I'm going to go for this test website is Cooking Time with Tim.com. And you want to put the .com in there just to make sure that it's showing you the .com options. Okay, and we're going to go click search, and it was available, so I can click add for $0. And now we've got our payment methods, but we want to make sure that we're getting exactly what we want and nothing extra. So over here on the right, you'll see sort of the summary of what is being set up. So we've got a setup fee. There's no setup fee. That's great. Domain privacy, as I was saying before, this sort of hides your information by putting it behind Dreamhost's information so that you don't get a bunch of spam email or phone calls or junk mail in the mail. And then we get the domain name here that we signed up for. And we want to have WordPress pre-installed, and that's just going to get us going immediately. We're not going to have to do anything to get WordPress set up, so that's great. I don't like the WP website builder, as I said, so just uncheck that. We just don't need any extra things on your WordPress website. And that's kind of one of the keys to making sure that your experience with WordPress goes as smoothly as possible, is to just not have any extra plugins, any extra themes. You want to have just what you need on your website. As next thing, I do recommend this Dream Shield protection. I kind of wish that they just included this, but it does scan for malware and malicious code. But I would say right in the beginning, it's definitely optional. So I'm actually going to uncheck this. So, but I do think that $3 for this protection is worth it. It's just extra money. And if you don't have extra money right now, you know, don't do it. But just think later on down the road, you should get some protection for your website. Okay, so that's going to bring our total to $59.40. This G Suite is a free 30-day trial, which of the Google's professional email for businesses. I think if you're just starting out, just use the email that they provide you. Once you start making money with your website, then you can go and get G Suite or one of the other more professional email services. Then all you need to do is just either choose to use a credit card or a PayPal account to check out. And then after you fill out your billing information, whether it's with PayPal or with a credit card, scroll down to here to the bottom, double check that we have the things that we want here. So definitely pre-install WordPress. The Dream Shield protection is optional. And then click Submit Order. Okay, and then after signing up, they're gonna go ahead and set up your hosting for you. They're gonna get, if you signed up for a domain name, they're gonna get WordPress installed. If you didn't sign up for a domain name, you should have WordPress also being installed on a temporary domain, and that way either when you decide your domain and you decide to register it with Dreamhost, you can do that, or if you decide to point your domain to Dreamhost, you can also do that and still have your website hosted with Dreamhost. Okay, so now while WordPress is installing and while our hosting is getting set up, we should actually be able to set up our email. So let's go ahead in here and click Complete Setup, and it's going to take us right into starting and creating an email address at our own domain. So we've got our domain name here, and now if you have multiple domain names that you're using with Dreamhost, you could select from your different domains that you already own. But since we just signed up, we just have this one domain name, so we'll go ahead and set this up. And you can set it up to whatever you want. I mean, it could be info at your domain, or in this case, I like to use Tim at my domain, so we're just gonna put in Tim here. And give the mailbox sort of the name, who it's coming from. If you're using info at your domain, you might put your domain name here. I'm going to put my name. And then you can choose to pick a password for you, or you can pick your own password. And I definitely recommend using some sort of password manager. For example, I use LastPass. When you start getting into the, online world just in general, but especially when you're making websites, there's going to be a lot of accounts that you need to sign up for. So having a good password manager like LastPass is definitely really helpful for this. We're going to keep this checked just to make sure that we have a large enough size email address. And now this has an option in for your emails to sort of automatically clean them up for you. So that's something that you're going to want to think about on your own, how you want to do that. But basically, when your inbox reaches 250 messages, it's automatically going to archive them. Or if the message has been sitting in there for more than 45 days, it's automatically going to archive them. So these are settings that you can change. It's going to keep those emails as long as you have space on your mailbox, which you should have plenty of space. But it's going to just automatically archive those for you. And you can choose to have whether you want it to automatically archive unread messages, and then which folder it's going to archive those messages to. So in this case, it's old messages. You can change that if you'd like. Then go ahead and create address. Now we got this set up, and we've got our total mailbox size at 25 gigabytes. That's what this is showing right here. And now let's go ahead and just create one more standard email address like this, and we'll just show you how that works. And just the reason why I wanted to show you a second email address is you'll see down here that you have a choice of how much disk space you would like this account to have. So I definitely recommend making it at least 2,000 megabytes, so that's 2 gigabytes, but you might want to make it like 10,000 megabytes, just so you have plenty of space for your email down the road. So let's call this one info. You can give it a name, give it a password, and then of course make sure you set this to something higher. I think that 10,000 megabytes is good. And then we've got the same settings here about removing email, and then we can click Create Address. Okay, so now I've got two sort of standard email inboxes. They're both accessible, and we've got the email setup information over here, so you can use your email client to check mail. You definitely want to use the IMAP settings here, because that's going to make sure that your mail stays on the Dreamhost server. And that's gonna be great for when in the future you move to a different mail service, or if you decide to move to a different mail service, you'll have all the email on your server and you can transfer all of that email to the new mail service, and you don't have to worry about whether it's downloaded on this device or that device. It's all gonna stay on the server. So sort of the basics of the email setup, and it's pretty easy and straightforward, as you can see here, to set up professional email using Dreamhost. You can also access webmail, so you can just go to a web browser, and you're going to go to, as we can see here, webmail.whatever your domain name is. So in my example, it's webmail.cookingtimewithtim.com, and you're going to be able to check your email there, and you're going to be able to sign in using the credentials that you created when you created your email addresses. Okay, so now let's go back and let's see how our website's doing and if WordPress is all set up. And so WordPress here is all set up. With the default way that Dreamhost sets it up, you can actually log into the back end of your WordPress website by clicking right here. You can also go to your domainname.com/wp-admin, and that's another way of logging into your website. And let's go ahead and open up the WordPress editor. Okay, so here we've got WordPress set up, and now we're getting this warning up here that says that there's an auto-generated password being used for our account. And so if we go over to the profile page, or if we go over to users, all users, or users profile, so what you can see here, what's happened here is that Dreamhost has automatically created this user here. So when you see this username, don't get freaked out that your website's been hacked. This is the automatically generated username so that you can log in from your Dreamhost backend here directly into your WordPress website. And if we go over here to all users, you'll see this username here. I don't believe you can change the name. I don't think you can change the actual username here. That's locked in, but you can change the nickname. So if you wanted to put your own name here, and this is the name that's going to show up on your posts and the pages when you create them as the author's name, and then you can decide whether you want it to show up as the username or as the name you add in here. You can also go over here to all users, and you can click add new at the top. And then you can create a new username and give it something that's easier for you to remember. Like for me, I would use something like Real Website Hints. Type in your email address, add in my first and last name, my website, and then create a password. And now, and make sure you set this to administrator, very important. And then you can sign in using this username here, Real Website Hints, and the password that you created. And that's when you go to the name of your domain slash wp-admin. That's how you log into the back end of your website. Let's go take a look at the plugins that they've installed, and I'm just gonna kind of explain these to you, and you can decide whether you wanna use them. So some of the things that I like to get rid of pretty much immediately are Hello Dolly. It's kind of a pointless plugin, so we can just click delete there. Jetpack, this is the free version of Jetpack, but I do feel like Jetpack is an excellent plugin to have. It does a lot of things that sort of make your website run better. It gives you some statistics on your website. And I feel like it's really easy to use, and it's the plugin that's brought to you by the makers of WordPress. So I think it's definitely very valuable. There's a bit of setup to it. You need to set up a WordPress.com account in order to activate it. But it does add a lot of like great functionality to your website. So it's definitely something I recommend setting up. And perhaps sometime in the future, I will do a tutorial on how to set up Jetpack. Now these Google Analytics, if you want to use Google Analytics to get some better information about your WordPress website, this is actually a pretty good plugin to use. I'm going to delete it because I don't plan on using that for this website, and sort of the fewer plugins that you have installed on your website, the better. It just makes it easier to manage and just helps you head off any potential issues that you might have. Now this WP Supercache plugin is something you want to leave installed. That's something that's been created by Automatic, which is the company behind WordPress, and it's something that Dreamhost is recommending for your WordPress website to make sure that it runs as fast as possible. And this WP Forms Lite is something that can come in handy for adding contact forms and things like that to your website, so we can go ahead and leave that installed. So it's pretty much everything that we've got now set up and configured, and in the next steps, we'll be actually building our website. So I just want to give you guys one final reminder here, and that there's two ways to log into your website. One is you can go in and you can log into Dreamhost, and on the back end you can click on this card, log into your website. Or the other option is to just type in your domain name slash wp-admin and you can log into your website there. All right, so I hope that went smoothly for you. We should now have our hosting set up, we should have WordPress installed, and we should have email, professional email, at our own domain. The next step is to start building our website. Now, if you're watching this inside one of my tutorial playlists on YouTube, go ahead and click on the next video. And if you just landed on this video and you're not sure where to go next, check out my theme reviews, where I'll help you find the best theme for you to build the kind of website that you're looking to build. One of the most popular themes on WordPress and one of the most flexible themes is the Divi theme. So definitely check out that theme review. But if you're a little bit more targeted and you know what you want to do, go ahead and check out some of my more targeted theme reviews. I'm Tim from RealWebsiteHints.com. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.